Yes, good morning beta, welcome back. We are continuing the chapter, the transport of materials in plants and animals. This is the assignment based third video for the fourth weeks of October. Okay, in this we will be discussing three activities, activity 2, activity 3 and one more activity, that is activity 4 that is coming up. Okay, it's not a 4, it is 5. So what I will, you know, in the activity 2, you can see in the picture, experimental investigation, you are taking a plant. You are taking a plant and keep that roots, clean the roots of the plant. Which plant you can say, you can take balsam plant, very soft stem plants. Balsam or peperomia. Balsam or peperomia plant, you can take any of these one plant. And clean the roots. You have to pluck the plant along with the roots. Clean the roots, then keep the roots in a pot containing, a pot or a vessel containing red colored water. This is the red color water, R-E-D, red color. Okay? Red colored water. After a few hours, you keep this plant, the roots inserted in such a way that complete roots of these plants are dipped and immersed in the red solution. So after some time you can see that the water, red water passing through the xylem, red water move through the xylem, you can see red water moving through the xylem and make the stem red in color. Now what you have to do, you take this plant and cut this cross section, take a thin slice, you can take a slice and keep it in the glass vial and see through the microscope. You can see that the xylem and phloem, this is a vascular bundle, xylem and phloem together form a vascular bundle. This vascular bundle become red in color. Xylem and phloem both inside of the vascular bundle become red in color because of the red color water is conducted or transported through the xylem. So xylem, you can see xylem is this and phloem is this. Xylem is this, phloem is this. But both xylem and phloem you can see red. But more xylem is red in color. More xylem is red in color. What it indicates? The water absorbed from the soil is transported to the xylem. You got this idea? Very clear? Yes, very clear. Now we are coming to the next activity, that activity 3. This activity you can do at home. Okay? In this activity, you have to take a plant, a thick stemmed potted plant. Thick stemmed potted plant you can take. Thick stemmed potted plant. Now what you have to do, you know the outside of the stem is phloem and inside is xylem, we know that. Inside of this is xylem and outside is phloem. So what you can do, you can cut this phloem in a circle around the stem. You take a fine knife and cut this in a circle and remove the phloem. Now this part phloem is removed. Phloem is removed. You keep it in the sunlight for a few days or even 1 week. After 1 week or 2 weeks, you can understand that the upper part of the plant where you cut, the food gets accumulated here in the upper part. Because in the region, in this region, the phloem is removed so that the food cannot come down. Food cannot come down. So it indicates that the food is accumulated and this upper part of this cut edge is over. It is due to the accumulation of the food. It indicates that the food is prepared in the leaf and it is transported downward direction also. But here we can understand the water they absorb, the roots absorb the water which is conducted through the xylem and only moving in the upward direction. No downward direction. Here, phloem transport food from the leaf is conducted downward direction as well as upward direction. So the food has accumulated here, hence having no phloem here in the cut part, the food is stopped here, accumulated and becomes swollen. So these two activities indicate that the water and minerals are conducted through the xylem and food is transported through phloem. Now we are coming to the fifth activity. In the fifth activity, we can say we can also take a potted plant. What we can take? A potted plant. This is a pot. Okay? And you are taking a potted plant. Potted plant. And that plant with a lot of leaves. Okay, this is a potted plant. Now this potted plant with more water and healthy potted plant. Okay, right? You are covering this potted plant with a polythene cover. And tie it here. This is a polythene cover. Polythene bag or cover. After some hours, you can see the water drops accumulates inside the polythene bag. What does it indicate? After some time keeping in the sunlight, they perform photosynthesis. And what happens? The water is given out during transpiration. Okay. So both photosynthesis and transpiration take place inside the plant, inside the cover, because sunlight is available. When photosynthesis takes place, more water is produced. And as a result, we can understand that the more water is given out through the stomata, this water drops attached to the interior part of the polythene bag. So it indicates that plants perform transpiration. Plants perform transpiration. Plants perform transpiration. So you got this idea? These three activities you can do at your home. Thank you.